in the lion's sails. Lion's sails and greatest deal.
Don't you fall behind.
Mind you, I heard the pain.
Let's go.
Whoa there! I wonder if I know the poor beggar.
That's a girl. Keep moving. Steady on. That's the way. Easy does it. Off you go.
I'm with ya.
If only I knew which shipment it was, and I could trace the weapons to their owner.
Capital idea, Freddy.
Here we are, the shipping docks. Now, where are the Cockham crates intended for Mr. Plutus?
Everything you need, right here!
I don't have time for this. Streets clear!
Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Where the devil is it? Hello. And now to wait for the crates to be retrieved.
Don't want them tea leaves turned to dust, do we?
Protect these crates. Any mistake will cost you dearly.
Keep your knickers on. We hear ya.
Good, because I ain't repeating myself.
It's a shame I can't stop in for a pint. They're nervous. I should keep my distance. I bet Greenie's tailing Evie right about now. Good luck. Templars. Ah, yes. Lead me to Mr. Plutus. Hmm. Templars. Ah, yes. Lead me to Mr. Plutus. Walk on, girl. Whoa, now! Doing fine, girl. Who's a good horse? You are. Doing fine, girl. Steady on. Keep moving. Let's go. That's a girl. That's the way. Walk on, girl. Who's a good horse? You are. Steady on. Doing fine, girl. Keep moving. That's the way. Let's go. Easy, girl. Easy.
Weapons are here.
Same routine as before. The Twopenny opens a vault, we robs it and leaves the money in his storehouse. Look sharp, the boys are waiting.
To the Bank of England. Yeah.
Plutus is Twopenny.
Thank you.
Well, what say you?
You're not gonna like it.
Now, see here. I am graced with the Abilene family's robust constitution.
Two pennies rob in the Bank of England.
The governor of the bank. I think I might need to sit down.
There's no time for that. Bastard's probably deep in the vault by now.
However you get in, I don't want to know.
Of course. But do you know how I can get in?
The bank is designed to protect England's gold reserves. A fortress, guarded under lock and key. There is the bank manager, Mr. Osborne. Only he is allowed free access to the vault. You can spot him near the entrance. And, oh yes, one man keeps a close watch on the vault door. He watches it like a hawk. If he sees you, he's sure to see it. The guard captain, Gus Howard, knows Twopenny well. He is in on this, I'm certain. Mr. Fry, please use discretion. The only way to implicate Twopenny is to catch him in the act. Do not jeopardize him. No big displays. This is the Bank of England. If you encounter any trouble, I'll be in the atrium. In disguise.
Twopenny won't be leaving that vault. Fancy. Fitting for Twopenny's tomb.
Now, I'll take you in and you'll see everything is perfectly secure.
The official bank tour is leaving soon. Last chance to join our group and learn of the great wonders of the bank.
The accounting appears impeccable, my dear. I shall update our ledgers accordingly. Do you require assistance in any other matter?
No.
Official bank tour is leaving soon. Last chance to join our group and learn of the great wonders of the banking world.
Thank you.
Now, please, don't harm me. I'll assist you. What would you have me do?
I rather fancy a private tour of the vault.
Right this way, sir. The records are stored in here.
Clumsiness! By now. He's in the vault!
You've stolen your last shilling from the people of London.
Those animals squander their savings. We are the experts in investment. Nothing would be built or improved. Nothing would rise above the muck without our hand guiding. No creating the future. They benefit as much as their worth.
It is their city, not yours.
Without our investments, there would be no city.
For the path of the dead.
Thank you.
police! We're saved!
Arrest them all for robbing the people of England. The Bank of England is closed until further notice. The currency, a laughingstock. Inflation out of control, twopenny brutally murdered.
And yet Parliament does nothing.
The bill will be defeated, sir. That buffooned Disraeli shall be taken care of. It has been arranged, upon my honor.
Your honor carries little weight.
How dare you, sir!
The poor people of this city have suffered enough. Today I granted a significant rise to my staff in order to counter inflation.
What?
I would supply all of London if I could. Meanwhile, you sit in your club and wax poetic with promises your honor cannot pay. Your family's fortune, however. I wonder what they would offer to keep your record out of the newspapers. About the same as Disraeli would offer for your balls, I'd wager. But let's be generous. Why limit ourselves to one or the other, when we can have it all? What say you, sir? Shall I come collect? No more dallying. The halls of Parliament must be free to govern. Again! Understood? You may see yourself out.
A letter. For me? Dear Mr. Starrick, men hired. Strike tomorrow. Disraeli's death will stall Corrupt Practices Act indefinitely. Gladstone will be far more pliable. May the father, etc., etc., be. So Starrick's got his finger in politics, has he? I need to enter the Sinopian Club and find out who B is.
Tread delicately around Parliament.
As if I don't usually.
Your indiscretion at the Bank of England caused British currency to nearly collapse.
Nearly is the operative word. Speaking of collapses, what of the key you found that unlocks very little?
Henry took it for research. I am confident that the vault is ours.
Nearly ours, Evie. Nearly. A letter. For me?
Walk on, girl.
Cipher. Perhaps we have met before, perhaps not. You search for an artifact. Let me show you the truth.
Position of the second wave.
1 hour away, at most.
My pint and needs to die. All the little piggies have done awful things.
Stop right there.
That's not very polite.
Even in these trying times, we must never forget the laws of common courtesy. Arms down. We appear to have been following the same trail, Miss Rye.
I got here first.
Indeed, you are to be commended. I fear, however, that we have not wholly rooted out evil in this vicinity.
There's another radio.
Accompany me, if you would be so kind. That second device must be found, or new waves of Zeppelins will soon blanket the heavens.
Short on soldiers, are we?
If you could put your considerable talents to good use at Tower Bridge, you would have the thanks of a brave but beleaguered nation.
I would settle for the right to vote.
afraid now. Where is it? The radio's close to the river, but I need more than this.
Someone's kicked the bucket.
The seven is mine. I'm the king of the cucumbers. The seven is mine. Don't be going on. Another one's a white figure.
Clever. The radio's in the breach itself. North Tower. I should drop by and say hello.
Contagious.
Demons everywhere.
Another one.
Yeah.
used.
Let us postpone celebrations. One of the bloody blimps has broken through. Not worry. I have a contingency plan.
reach the Zeppelin from here, but we can shoot down their escorts.
Heartwarming sight, Miss Fry.
Your remarkably armed boat deserves a share of recognition.
One of my experimental projects when I was Lord of the Admiralty. I haven't always been a man of shadows.
And I suppose this victory will thrust you back into the limelight.
We may have struck a blow against the enemy, but London is still riddled with German agents. Currently, there's a new group, unlike anything I've seen before. Theirs is a fanatical, almost religious fervor.
And you believe I'm the woman to flush them out?
Indeed. I dare not approach Mr. Asquith without firmer evidence, but I believe they pose an immediate threat. If you concede to this, I give you my word that once I've battled my way back into Parliament, I shall see if something can't be done about your request. As you're aware, a vote can be far more lethal than a bullet or a blade.
To tell you a story. It is our story.